Hey, listen, we've all had the nerves when we go into a job interview, and we stutter and stammer maybe just a little bit. But you know what? Compared to some of these people out there, we're doing great. Author of The Old School Advantage and communications expert Jim Whitten joins us this morning on Memphis Morning News. Jim, thanks for joining us here in Memphis. How are you?
Good, Tim. My pleasure.
All right. Hey, thank you for joining us. Hey, first question is, where do you see yourself in 5 years? No, I'm kidding. That would be a job interview question. CareerBuilder.com, apparently the annual list is out of some of the job interview faux pas. Can you tell us a little bit about how they compile this list?
You know, obviously they went to 2,600 HR pros, and then they boiled it down to 10 winners.
Okay.
Probably my two favorites are the one that said her hair was perfect, and that's why she should become part of the team. And then the fellow that ate crumbs off the table, which is, I don't know if that's symbolic or he was trying to send a message, but those two got my attention.
If he's trying to send a message, I guess the message would be, next. Seems kind of bizarre. So, okay, so eating crumbs off of the hiring manager's table, that's... Huh, and then perfect hair. Oh, okay. All right. Now, when I think of job faux pas, I think of the stuttering, maybe some stammering, or maybe, you know, maybe there's some salad caught between the teeth or anything like that. Any food-related faux pas in these worst interview or weirdest interview mistakes?
Well, one guy brought a pizza in with him, which certainly would be, I think, a food faux pas, put it in that category. But, you know, Tim, it's so easy. I mean, some other things, the don't call us, we'll call you rejection. They also did a category in that regard. Answering the phone call, 64% of HR directors said if you answer a phone call, you're out. And then dressing inappropriately, about 49% said there. And, again, that's so easy to dress properly to make a first impression. I mean, here's really all you have to think about, and that is red, white, and blue. A blue blazer, a red tie, and a white or light blue shirt or blouse takes care of all of that. And now you've got a neutral base in terms of nothing that's distracting them in the way you look, and now they can pay attention to your visage, your personality, your character, your knowledge, that kind of thing.
Jim Whitten is the author of The Old School Advantage, and he's a communications expert. They say confidence is the key oftentimes to landing a job interview. Can confidence go overboard, Jim?
Well, certainly it can, but I think the right amount of confidence can come from just a few things in preparation. I mean, do your homework. Go to the website. Memorize their values. Try to use one or two as you're talking with them and answering questions back to them. Mm-hmm. Make sure your online personal postings are in good order or cleaned up. If they're not and you go in there and you know they're not cleaned up, that could affect your confidence. And then just introduce yourself to everyone. Relax. I mean, whether it's the driver from the airport, if that's the case, because they're going to ask the driver about you oftentimes, or it's the first person you meet when you walk in. Maybe that's the receptionist. Just be courteous to everyone because that tells a lot about you.
All right. Well, now regarding these phone, was there any information on when you talked about phone calls being kind of a goofy way to torpedo the interview? Did any of those make the top 10? Did anybody get a phone call from maybe another job or maybe ask about the money or anything like that? Do you recall that in that top 10 winners list?
They did. Actually, one of them called his wife to ask her if the starting salary was enough before continuing the interview. Okay, this wasn't after the interview. This was in the midst of the interview. And so the rule there, just so you won't forget to not call your wife, is never talk money in the first interview unless the interviewer brings it up. Otherwise, that's a second interview or a follow-up topic.
Okay. It just blows my mind that somebody at some point in their mind they had to go, okay, well, this is a good idea. That's just nuts. What about arrogance? We talked about confidence. Anybody talk a little bit too much?
Well, actually, appearing arrogant, 59% of those HR directors said that's a good way to never get a call back. Mm-hmm. But arrogance can be shown, or lack of arrogance, humility, I should say, can be shown as well. I mean, arrive on time. Don't ever arrive late. That's kind of a clue of arrogance, and I know traffic can be an issue, and sometimes you can't help it. But, you know, I've always told my kids, if you're not early, you're late. There is no in-between. Mm-hmm. Again, don't look at your electronic devices. There's nothing so important out there that it can't wait. And if you're looking at your devices, it may presume some arrogance. This one, a lot of people don't think of. Don't wear heavy perfume or cologne because you don't want your interviewer sneezing because you walked in the room. So little things like that.
Yeah, absolutely. And you don't want to leave a legacy in the elevator either with heavy perfume. Then they'll remember you for hours after the fact. Jim Whitten, check out his work, The Old School Advantage. He's a communications expert too. Jim, hey, it's nice to talk to you. I don't think we've spoken with you before here in Memphis. We really appreciate your time and hope that you're not a stranger here in Memphis on Memphis Morning News.
It's my pleasure, Tim. Take care now.
Thank you. You too. All right. I think without Karen here, safe to say, Sherry, we can circle him. We like him, right? Yeah, he was good. So somebody ate a pizza that was brought with him and then asked if the starting salary was enough in the middle of the interview, called his wife. I guess at that point, when he hangs up, he's thinking, I guess that's really not an important point anymore since I've just blown my interview. So thank you so much, Jim.